Isaiah 53. Surely he took up our pain and bore our suffering, yet we considered him punished by God, stricken by him, and afflicted. But he was pierced for our transgressions, he was crushed for our iniquities. The punishment that brought us peace was on him, and by his wounds we are healed.
Welcome to our Good Friday service this morning, and welcome to those watching online. I just want to have a quick reminder that we do have Resurrection Sunday services this Sunday, and they're at our regular church service times at 9, 15, and 11. We will have a choir and some baptisms as well during the service. The service looks a little bit differently. Today we are going to be reading through John 18 and John 19, but through a dramatic reading. And during the dramatic reading, there are a couple parts where it'll say congregation on the screen, and we invite you to participate. And for some of you, it may feel weird to say things like crucify him, because sometimes we like to think that maybe we wouldn't say that. But this is just to symbolize that we are all complicit in Jesus' death and sacrifice, that we are all sinners. And so I invite you guys to participate by saying the words on the screen when it is time. As well, after each reading, each portion, we'll have a song, and I won't get you to stand for each song, but I will get you to stand for the first and the final song. So I invite you now to rise, please, in body as you're able and in spirit, as we hear our call to worship. Slowly, we come to worship on this Holy Friday. Reluctantly, we hear the story of Jesus' suffering. Bleakly, we follow Jesus to the cross. Humbly, we acknowledge our part in his passion. Deeply, we yearn to understand the depth of this sacrifice. Solemnly, we gather this day to pray and worship together, giving thanks for our Savior, Jesus Christ.
Rid me of myself, I belong to you. Oh, lead me.
Judas has done his job. Jesus has been arrested and his disciples have scattered. Only a few hours earlier, he was questioned by the high priest. His face shows the bruising and swelling from a beating he received from the temple guard. Peter has already fulfilled the prophecy of Jesus and denied him three times. It is now early in the morning and the night is almost gone. It is the time that Pilate will hear cases in his court. Jesus arrives at Pilate's house and is taken inside. The Jews who have taken him there remain outside. It is the time of the Passover, and the Jews must remain ceremonially clean. If they enter the house of a Gentile, they will be unclean for the feast. They have murder in their hearts, but they want to keep their hands clean to celebrate the deliverance of the Lord.
Another case of fighting and disagreement among these people that I'm supposed to rule. My job is to keep the peace, but sometimes I have to get brutal with them. Sometimes I find myself in the middle of their religious squabbles, and I simply don't have the interest or the knowledge to make an informed decision. Most often, I wish they would simply leave me alone. Here they come with another prisoner, another case to consider. Obviously, they've worked this one over already. What has this man done?
This man is a criminal. He is a threat. Why would we bring him to you if these things were not true?
If you're not going to answer me, then take him into your own courts and judge him.
But we want him dead, but we don't have the power to do it. You know, only you Roman governors have the power of life and death. If we had this power, we would have passed judgment ourselves.
by his own betrayed. The sin of man and wrath of God has been on Jesus' name. Silent as he stood accused, beaten, mocked and scorned, bowing to the Father's will, he took a crown of thorns. Oh, that rugged cross, my salvation.
Now the story is played out on two stages, with Pilate acting as the mediator between the two, leaving the Jews who remained outside the palace to avoid being made unclean. Pilate went inside to speak with Jesus.
They say that you are the king of the Jews. I've dealt with your kind before. I've often had to put down rebellions and kill their leaders, but you don't seem like the leader of a rebellion. Are you the king of the Jews?
Is that your own idea, or has someone planted it in your head? Have others talked to you about me?
Do I look like a Jew? Why would I care one way or another? My job is to make sure things around here go smoothly, so that the emperor gets good reports that your people are peacefully paying your taxes. What do I know about you and your claim to be a Jewish king? Your own people have handed you over to me. Obviously, I didn't order your arrest. Obviously, I didn't have you beaten or dragged here. But from the bruises and welts on your face, I can see that you're not very popular with them. What did you do to make them so angry? Why do they want you dead?
My kingdom is not of this world. If my kingdom were of this world, my servants would fight so that I should not be delivered to the Jews. My kingdom is from another place.
If you have a kingdom, you must be a king. Is that what you're telling me? You're a king?
You say correctly that I am a king. For this purpose I have been born, and for this I have come into the world, to testify to the truth. Everyone who is of the truth hears my voice.
What is truth?
All hail.
After questioning Jesus in the palace, Pilate went out to speak again to those gathered outside his house.
I can find no basis for any charge against this man. So listen up, all of you. You know that during the Passover, it is customary for me to grant you the release of a prisoner. So who will it be? Do you want me to release the King of the Jews? Or would you rather have Barabbas, the political criminal? And remember, Barabbas is a dangerous man. Whom will you choose?
No, not him. Free Barabbas.
Seeing that the strategy to free Jesus would not work, Pilate had Jesus flogged, which was one of the most cruel tortures. There are three different methods of flogging. One is fairly mild, the second is more brutal, and the third is often deadly. Jesus received the third kind. A crown of thorns was fashioned and pushed on his head. A purple rug was thrown around him as a royal robe. The soldiers punched him and spit in his face. Following this humiliation, Pilate brought Jesus out to face the crowd. He was bleeding and staggering as he made his way to meet those calling for his death.
Look, I'm bringing him out. I've examined him, and I find no basis for any charge against him. Now drop the charges. He has received a beating. He has been humiliated. Let him go free.
Crucify him! Crucify him! Crucify him!
Savior, say, thy strength indeed is small. Child of weakness, watch and pray. Find in me thine all in all. God is Jesus, paid it all to him. Crimson stain, he washed it white as snow. Lord, now indeed I find thy power alone can change the leper's thank you. complete. Jesus died my soul to save. My lips shall still repeat, 'cause Jesus paid it all. All to him I owe. Sin had left a crimson stain. He washed it white as snow, 'cause Jesus paid it.
Knowing that he had no basis to put this man to death, Pilate pleaded with the crowd.
I find no reason to put him to death. So if you want him dead, you take him and out and crucify him. But I can see no point in ending his life.
But we have a law, and according to that law, he must die because he claimed to be the Son of God. As you know, Pilate, your job is not simply to uphold the Roman laws. You also have to uphold our laws and customs. He claims to be a king, which is against Roman law, and he claims to be the Son of God, which is against our law. He must be put to death.
Upon hearing this, Pilate became very afraid. Who was this strange man? Why did these people hate him? Why did he say nothing in his own defense?
Jesus, where are you from? What is your background? Do you refuse to talk to me? Look at you. Your head and face are bleeding. Your back is laid open from the whip. Don't you know that I hold in my hands the power of life and death? I decide if you die or if you go free. All the authority in this situation belongs to me.
You would have no authority over me at all if it had not been given to you from above. For this reason, the one who handed me over to you has the greater sin.
Pilate could not understand this strange answer, but he made up his mind to set Jesus free. But those gathered outside his palace continued to shout,
"Crucify him! Crucify him! If you let this man go, you are no friend of Caesar. Anyone who claims to be king opposes Caesar. Crucify him."
Pilate knew that this was a serious charge. It would not be good for this kind of accusation to find its way back to Rome. Again, he brought Jesus out. It was about noon, the time of day when two things happened during the Passover feast. First, everyone stopped working. Second, the slaughter of the Passover lambs began. The lambs were killed so that the sins of the people might be forgiven, so that the angel of judgment might pass over them. Those gathered around Pilate's house needed to hurry along the execution so they could go home and celebrate the love of God in the Passover feast.
Again, I find no fault in this man. He claims to be a king, but he is harmless. What do you say?
Take him away. Take him away. Hang him on a cross. Crucify him.
Shall I crucify your king?
We have no king but Caesar. Crucify him.
Then let him be crucified.
I'm going to invite you to stand for our final song, please.
is our place where mercy reigns and never dies. There's our place where streams of grace flow deep and wide. Where all the love I've ever found comes like a flood, comes flowing. At the cross, at the cross, I surrender my life. I'm in awe of you. I'm in awe of you. Where your love ran red and my sin washed white, I owe all to you. I owe.
By his stripes, we are healed. By his wounds, we are made whole. Go in the name of Jesus Christ and live in the salvation made possible by the goodness of this Friday.